Hey guys, I have a BH Cosmetics haul for you today. I absolutely love BH Cosmetics. I had a first receive. I think my first BH Cosmetics things was like a bronzer quad and a Cult Cosmetics box, which I do not receive the Cult Cosmetics box anymore because I was just kind of tired of getting boring, two boring nail polishes and a little makeup thing for $25 a month. They are good nail polishes, but they have all these buy two get one free deals going on, and they don't really come out with a whole lot of new nail polishes. They come out literally like maybe two a month. So then they were also I do the buy two get one free. I buy like a bunch of nail polishes, like 6 to 9 a month at a time, and then the next month I would get like two of those in a box because they just send out that stuff anyway. So I stopped getting them, but I did get my first BH Cosmetics product in that Cult Cosmetics box. So then I really liked them and I was curious. And then I got another BH Cosmetics product somewhere else. And I was like, okay, let's do this. And I checked out the site and they're really fair price. They're really cheap. But they're really good quality makeup. It's like e.l.f. kind of. It's a decent price. They always have sales and their palettes are absolutely out of this world. I like e.l.f. for more of my face makeups and stuff and like different cool things that come out, and I like BH Cosmetics for my big palettes. I did haul a whole lot of BH Cosmetics like a month and a half ago. I wasn't doing videos then, so I don't have that haul. I do have two palettes out of that that I will show you, that I wanted to show you the neon palettes I had, and then another one that has neon in it. Just to kind of show you. But I have like a ton of stuff. Like I got a foundation, I got a pressed powder foundation, I got a concealer, color concealer, correcting palette, and I got all kinds of stuff. So this haul, I'm going to show you, and I will tell you the two palettes that I didn't get in this haul that I got in the last haul. I will let you know which ones those are when we get to them. I'm going to start off with this brush kit. I think it was like $11 or $12. Now I did have a coupon. This is the same day that I got my e.l.f. haul. I bought them the same day. It was like the day before or the day of taxes being due. So they had like a tax coupon or whatever, tax day coupon. And I was really interested in this brush kit because it had a few brushes that I don't have and that I wanted. And they're purple. I know the package was pink, but like the tips of the brush are purple. And this thing is absolutely incredible. I'm not gonna go through every single brush that's in here. I love BH Cosmetic brushes. I'm not gonna lie. I have another brush set from them that I got in my last haul. And I really wish I was doing videos on them because that was a really good haul, so I'm gonna spend quite a bit of money on that. I got like a lot of foundation brushes in that one, and they're nice. I was really interested in this eyeliner brush right here because I have the angled eyeliner brushes. I don't have the actual thin eyeliner brushes. This one does have an angled one too. And I do like the crease pencil-y brush that we have going on here. I do not have a fan brush of any type. So I was excited, and they are so soft. I'm telling you, BH Cosmetics has awesome brushes for super cheap. This whole thing was $12. Then I have my eyeshadow brushes and my powder brushes, and they're gorgeous, and they're cheap, and they're fluffy and soft. And I absolutely love this roll-up case. So totally worth it. Not gonna lie. Oh, and this haul, I got palettes. All of the palettes that I got in here. I have a smoky eye palette, a blush palette, and then three eyeshadow palettes. They were buy one, get one free in that sale. And then I had a coupon for so much percentage off my other stuff. So I'm sorry, I couldn't pass up buy one, get one free. That's insane. You know, $12 for a palette, you buy one and get. Oh, it's crazy. They have this new Forever Aqua Gloss nude. And if you watched my lip monthly video, which I've done tonight as well, along with 12 other videos, there's that Pergo Cosmetics lip gloss in there in light pink. And I had said that it was a had a heavy white base on it, and it's one that it will like make that line at the edge of your lip look a bit thick, tacky lip gloss. And this kind of does the same thing. I was expecting a little bit more from this lip gloss. Again, since I know how to use the Cargo Cosmetics one, it won't be so bad. It's not a normal doe foot applicator. It is one of those fuzzy, like, doe foot type applicators. It's not a brush, but it's, like, straight and funky. This one is called Honeysuckle. I was swatching on my hand, and you can kind of see what I mean. It's kind of, like, thick. It's a little sticky. This is one that you need to take on your finger and gently blot onto your lip. In the lightest touch ever, it has a very sweet vanilla-ish mouthfeel. But it's one of those you do not want to just glob it on your lips. You do need to blot it on your finger. You don't want to use a brush. You don't want, and that's the only way you're really going to get use out of it. Because it's one of those that's super thick. It's heavy on the white pigment in there to get it to be a bold color. And I don't know why companies are making this kind of lip product, because I don't want to go through the extra step of wiping it on my finger and then dabbing it on my lip. I don't want to deal with that, especially when it's out in public. So the problem with this is I paid for it, and I'm probably going to throw it in my lip gloss drawer, and I'm probably going to forget about it, and I'm probably not going to reach for it as much because it is an extra step that I have to go through. I can't just slap it on and go. This is one that has to go over another color, and it has to be blotted on with your finger. I will probably use it at some point, but this is not going to get a whole lot of use for me. And that makes me sad. I was really excited about trying these lip glosses that they came out with. It smelled really good. It's a very sweet smell. But I liked the idea of a opaque nude, and I'm thinking that maybe it's just something to do with making these glosses opaque, because I'm noticing all the ones that are really opaque have that white undertone in them, and it's just super sticky, super sticky. It's that white line, they're super thick, and then if it's hydrating the gloss, I don't know about that so much. It's just more like sticky and thick with the white undertone. I'm not a fan. This is the one time BH Cosmetics who let me down. I've never been let down by them before. This is it. It might get some type of use out of me, but, I mean, it did get some type of use out of me. Look, I just used it on camera for like a second. But, we're not going to be negative, Nancy. I'm just letting you know. See, it wipes off pretty okay with a makeup remover wipe, but my makeup remover wipes are re-oiled. Why I'm using them to wipe off swatches, because I have not put them on my eyes. I don't know where my grandma got these from. Okay, so I want to show you how the BH Cosmetics palettes are. I got some. Let me show you the blush one first, and then because I got one blush one and then the rest are eyeshadows. And with this, I would probably never need another blush. Life. I like the matte package on it. These are just one of those thin, slim packages. I like these. I know they're cheap. I know that's why companies use them, because they're cheap. Like, here's the blushes. We have 10 blushes in there. Ooh, these are not picking up on camera. These are super bright. They are coming off awfully. Now maybe that's a little bit better. They're incredible. This one right here is going to end up, it is kind of light. So it's probably going to end up as a blending color for me for eyeshadow, because I can't really use it. This one is really dark and might actually end up as an eyeshadow and a crease color for me. This is a dark brown. I don't know if I can pull it off as a touch color. The lightest of touch. These are really pretty buttery. They're not like that crazy powder consistency of like a cheap blush. They're pretty, they're good. And I have so many colors to choose from. I absolutely love these. I will put a couple of swatches for you. They are great. I am happy with this. I could probably survive with this blush palette for the rest of my life. Can you see more of them? A little bit more pigment. They're very pigmented. Very pigmented. Very nice. And I don't remember how much this cost. Again, I believe this was part of the... I think it was if you spent $50, you got free shipping. I was going for free shipping and something else. I was almost up there to free shipping, and it was like super close to free shipping. And the shipping, it was like $6 away from free shipping, and the shipping was like $5.99. So I was like, I might as well just get something else and actually get a product. If I'm going to pay the same amount, maybe I'll get a product and just get the free shipping. So I did that. I don't remember how much this was. It was probably less than $10. I'm sure it was less than $10. But I absolutely love this. And I'm not a big, huge, like, crazy over washes. I like them. I use them. I did not use one today. But I like them. I use them. But I like this palette. Like, it's a nice palette. So I'm happy with this budget. All right, I'm going to show you the two eyeshadow palettes that I got in my last haul. Just because these don't really have, well, I think one of them has like some bright, almost green colors, but not really. This I'm going to depot. I have a depot coming from eBay. And I'm going to depot it. I mean, it's cute packaging. It's got cardboard with the magnetic packaging. And here it is. It's not picking up. Like, this red is really neon. This pink is neon. This is a neon coral down here. This is definitely a neon lime. This is like a neon shimmery lime right here. This is a neon yellow. Here's the golden shimmery yellow. This is like a neon navy blue almost. I'm going to depot all of these colors. I'm going to depot these. This looks absolutely ridiculous. And then this flips up right here, which is also magnetic. And you have four blushes. One's a highlight, one's supposed to be a bronzer. It's kind of orange. I don't know if it's going to be a bronzer or not. I might depot it to my sister. And then two more blush colors. So I'm probably just going to cut right here because this has magnetic part right here to snap down. This is magnetic, this is magnetic. So I'm going to probably just cut right along the lines and save the blush palette. And maybe travel with that or stick it in my purse or something. And then I'm going to depot these into my deep palette over here and over here. But I do like this palette a lot. I like that red that's behind this green. With that being said, this is Take Me. That palette was, they have names, BH Hollywood, California Makeup Palette Collection, Special Edition. This one is 30 Color Palette, Take Me to Brazil. I actually did not get this in my last haul. I bought this separately because I wanted the neons, and I think they were continuing this. It came from Fairness Out. They accidentally sent me two. So, I'm giving them away for Christmas present because it's not open. I'm never going to go through this one because I have many instruments. And I really liked it because of like the neon greens, more neon greens, some shimmery neon greens, some yellows, some blue. And then I like down here, they give you a big pan of black, and then they give you this big pan of white. And this white, let's swatch it, but I know it's not going to come up. It has like this ever so light minty green shimmer in this white, and I absolutely love that. But this is, I wanted to show you, they have these gorgeous neon. And I know not everybody's in the bright color. I know a lot of people like this. This is like an aqua color. This is not showing up on camera. This is like a pretty aqua color. That's really good. I know that a lot of people are into neutrals. And that's great. I love neutrals too. I can do well with neutrals, but I love neon. And this palette is so incredible. I absolutely love it. So I just wanted to show you that we do have that. I don't know for how long, but they do have it. Okay, so now we're going to get into our other eyeshadow palettes that I got. First one I got was Wild at Heart, and these are baked eyeshadow palettes. And these colors are absolutely stunning. This purple is gorgeously bright. This is literally a hot pink. It's not coming up as a hot pink on there. Not so much, but it is. This one, it's not showing up at all as a hot pink. It is literally a neon pink, but it's shimmering in a baked eyeshadow. These are the baked ones. I absolutely love these. These are incredible. The purple is gorgeous. I mean, could that purple come up? Let me see if I can get that Not my crevice pieces lined in my hair. Still not coming up. That nail plant. Gosh, I got eyeshadow like taped into my fingers. So, again, that's three of them. I mean, and the pigment on these are insane for a baked eyeshadow. I said in another video that hard candy can turn me off of baked shadows. Here's my e.l.f. for you. These are even better than the e.l.f. ones. These are even more pigmented. They come off on your brush easier. They go onto your eyes easier. They stay. The color is amazing. I don't know why I've stayed away from baked eyeshadow for so long, but I will always buy these like baked eyeshadows. These are absolutely stunning. Incredible. With that being said, I also got Wild Child palette, which is another baked. Same idea. This one's more of a neutral palette. There's the dark plum purples in here. I got some taupe going on down here. Oh, this pretty shimmery white. I have shimmer white popping up everywhere. I can splash a couple of these. But these colors shimmer out so well, and they are just absolutely gorgeous. I cannot remember how much this cost. I want to say $10. Anywhere between $15 and $10. Again, I got them buy one, get one free. So I can't even beat that. Next palette I got is Dark Rose. And I'm like, how awesome is this? I love this design with the shifter's glow on it. This has blush eyeshadow and liquid eyeliner. I'm putting on the floor because I'm packing up my house and I don't know where else to put them. It's boxes. So I'm using my white wall right here and my son's little coloring lap table perfectly for my height on the floor. Okay, so here we go. Here's the eyeshadows up here. Here's our blushes down here. You know, liquid eyeliner. The liquid eyeliner I have used. I do like it. It's just a black. I will show it to you. Throat is starting to get sore. I have literally, this is like my 12th video tonight. I had so much stuff piling up. So many holes had come in. So much samples had come in. I was just going to try to wait until after I moved, but it was too much. And I didn't want to go without using all of my makeup for that long. I just had it sit in a box. Because I didn't want to have to try to figure out later what I needed. I didn't want to figure out what I needed later for the videos to try to put it back in. So I just went ahead and just started tonight. I wasn't going to even start doing a YouTube channel for 2 months. Because I am so busy between the two houses. So this is the black right in there. Super black, super liquid, super, it's a, finisher here. It's a felt tip. And it just fits right in that little package. After this video is done, this will come out and this will go in my drawer. That's what I like. I do like these shadows. They are a neutral type. These are not as shimmering and crazy pigmented as the baked ones. There's still a lot of pigment. I mean, look at that. That's just one little swatch. But they're definitely a different consistency. So when you're going from one to the other, it's definitely different. I don't know. I don't know if it's just, we're gonna find out right now. Is this waterproof? It does not say waterproof at all. Okay, so I guess I'm gonna have to add this to the other video because it just put me off. It doesn't say that it's waterproof on this eyeliner, but it is still not all the way off. I'm gonna just go ahead and it. So that was the Dark Rose palette. On to my last palette, we got this one. It is Smoky Eyes, 28 colors. I love it. Okay, look at those colors. They're gorgeous. They're shimmery. I have one matte and a couple that are like satin. They're almost a matte. This pink right here is a matte color. It's just a light rosy pink. I like it. I don't know which ones to swatch for you, but I'll just pick a couple. These are buttery. Like, I know that's a good thing when we're talking about our shadow. Blow me out of water. These are gorgeous. Look at those. That's insane. The pigments on these are just incredible. Definitely not a letdown. Each cosmetic has not let me down. The only thing that's let me down so far, I've got a lot of makeup, is that aqua lip gloss that I just showed you guys a little bit ago. Other than that, this looks great. I absolutely love it. So I would suggest checking them out. Even if you only get like one or two little palettes, it's totally worth it. They have sales, they have coupons all the time. I would check them out. I love them. I check them out frequently. So if I do any more hauls from them, I will definitely post some videos. Obviously, anything I get from this point on, whether it's free stuff, whether it's samples, whether it's a haul, whatever, I will be reviewing and posting for you. So I will see you guys later.